There's a kind of hush all over the world tonight. Philly, you could light it up, baby. You could share it up now.
Let me see
all
what I
over
can
the
do.
world, you can hear the sounds of lovers in love.
Lovers in love.
Forever and ever, just the two of us.
25.
And nobody else. Oh, you're going into Chicago already, huh?
Yeah, man.
Chicago?
Yeah, I'm in the mood. I'm in the mood for Chicago.
Hold on. I'm just going to share up over here. Bump, bump, bump. Put it on this page. Put it on that page. And she's off and running. Philly Kid, what's going on, baby?
Not much, buddy. Just hanging out. It's a nice day here in Oklahoma.
Veterans Day. I got my Hero for Life shirt on. I got it working. Very comfortable.
Nice.
If there was ever a day for people to support their veterans, today is the day to do it.
It's the day.
We'll talk about that a little bit. I mean, listen, we support disabled vets all year long with our HeroForLife.us.
Yep.
And lots of contributions being made to disabled vets. Great show yesterday. Really cool. Right.
Yeah.
Ian Buchanan was cool yesterday talking about General Hospital and his 13-minute short film, Shutter the Doors, which was really cool. Great cinematography,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, yeah. My wife loved the show, man. Of course,
yeah.
big fan of Ian Buchanan. And,
mine too.
And I
mine
actually,
too.
His short film, Shutter the... What's the name?
Shutter the Doors.
Shutter the Doors.
And yeah, yeah.
I watched that like six times yesterday, and
yeah,
I'm about to get the dialogue memorized, man.
That's good. Yeah, that's a good one to work off of. The acting was fantastic. And speaking
yes.
of which, Philly Kid, we have a great show today. Mukesh Modi is coming up. He is the award-winning filmmaker. The Elevator. You remember back in, I think it was over the summer, we had Eric Roberts was on and Eugenia Kuzmina was on promoting The Elevator. I guess they had just finished. The trailers
yeah.
had come out and they were getting ready. And it's coming out on Amazon on the 18th. So Mukesh
Can't
is
wait.
Here. Guy was born and raised in India. And now he's just, he's a Hollywood powerhouse. And also, we just added this morning, Jeff Coffey. Formerly
yes.
of the group Chicago.
Nice.
Bass player, lead singer of Chicago. He's got his own music out. He was on with us back in June.
Yep.
Talented guy. So we have an amazing show coming up here on Veterans Day. You, of course, our resident veteran. You'll be singing a little later on. Suki, this is her final day on her assignment out in Phoenix. She'll be back with us next week. We'll all be back together, but we have some kind of show today, my friend.
I know, man. As you know, and that is, again, it goes back to the testament of your hard work. Everything you do for the show has made it, you and Suki have made it a worldwide event. I mean, we have people watching from around the world. And
It's wild. It's funny because when I'll see someone from... from the Isle of Malta.
Yep.
We had somebody watching the other day and Bali, I think, and Australia.
Yeah.
And it's just
Kuwait.
It's amazing.
New Zealand.
So funny. Yeah, New Zealand, right.
Germany, Australia. It's Singapore. It's worldwide, man. People don't realize it. And it is. It really
unreal,
is.
Man. Well, listen, we got big time filmmaker, director Mukesh Modi's coming up. Jeff Coffey from formerly of Chicago. You ready to start the show officially, Philly Kid?
Let's do it, Scotty.
The Suki and Scott Show.
This is one of the funnest shows I've ever done.
Hey, hey, when you're with me, I'm smiling.
It's musical. It's magical.
Suki and Scott, the Seven of Hearts.
Woo!
Exactly.
This is a sexy show.
Someone's getting some action.
Now, these larger-than-life personalities are on an exciting new journey as they bring you The Suki and Scott Show.
You guys, I nailed it. You're great. You ask great questions. You listen.
I answer you because I have respect for you guys, and it was a question
respectfully put.
The Suki and Scott Show is your one-stop destination for humor.
You like De Niro and Kate Pierre. Counselor!
Entertainment.
Jesse's girl!
Wonderful!
Can you paint with all the colors of the wind?
And optimism.
You guys have such amazing energy.
Ultraviolet light, it gets in there and it just fights the kung flu. Is that right? Okay.
Let's laugh together.
We love him.
The Suki and Scott Show.
Oh, yeah, Philly kid. Show number 256 today. As we roll along from the start of the pandemic. Now, of course, today's Veterans Day. You remember, it's been a year already since we had the Veterans Choir on. Can you believe that? Remember we had the Veterans Choir?
Yeah.
I just look back at that. I'm like, holy cow, it's been a year already. And it's wild. You know, Suki and I, when we were back at doing our morning show, we used to host the Veterans Parade in New York City. Mm-hmm. That was always a cool day. I found a little something of this guy. This is you back in the day. How old were you here, Phil?
I was 18 years old.
Wow, 18 years old. Air Force, right?
Air Force, at the time, they called us security policemen. And, you know, 18 years old, I was ready to take on the world. And all I ever wanted to do is defend those who, you know, couldn't defend themselves. And I did that for a lifetime. And so, man, thank you.
That's wild. Look at you, man.
Yeah, I love that photo.
Look at you. Now, did you know that I was also in the military?
Were you in the military in 1950?
That's my father. For when he was in the Air Force. And I mean, we kind of look alike, no?
Yeah, you guys... You are like his clone, man.
Yeah, I swear to God, we look exactly alike.
Wow. And that is a good looking man, and
it's wild. God, he had so much. His hair was so much better than mine. I'm a little pissed off about that.
You know, it skips a generation, so I guess it skipped yours.
It's killing me, man. Killing me. But anyway, so it's Veterans Day, and we're gonna we'll do more about that later on. I know you're gonna sing a little bit later on. Jeff Coffey's coming up. Used to be with the group Chicago.
Yep.
He's got, his own music out called Origins, which is all insane cover versions of some great songs. But first we have, Mukesh Modi is here, and he is the gentleman who made the film, The Elevator. We had Eric Roberts on, had a lot of fun with Eric. Eugenia Kuzmina was on, and the movie just looks fantastic. It's coming out on Amazon on the 18th. Which is, let's see, if Friday's tomorrow's the 12th, so that's 6th, so that's next Thursday, if my math is correct, the 18th. I'm going to show you a little bit of it, and then we will bring Mukesh in right after this. Take a look. Here's nice. The elevator.
May I speak to Roman?
No, sorry.
911 operator, do you need police, fire, ambulance?
No, my husband is missing.
My dad's missing.
He's gonna be home soon, babe.
No! Where is he?
Come on, guys, let's go. Let's find this guy.
Can you? There he is, ladies and gentlemen.
Nice.
Mukesh, you got to undo your microphone. You have to unmute your mic. Can you? There we go. There he is. How are you, my friend?
Good, good. First, thank you, Scott. Thank you, Phil. And I do remember, Scott, you're looking more younger than what I met you last time. And I was looking at the picture of both of you. Like, you guys still look handsome. And I saw the picture when you guys were in the military of your father, Scott. Yes.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
He looks like you. So you should be proud.
Very, very proud, Mukesh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
How are you,
amazing.
My friend?
I love your show. And thank you for inviting again. And thank you to you and to your show and also to your audience who's giving you so much love.
Thank you, my friend. Yeah, we've been talking about The Elevator for a while because, you know, like I was saying, Eric was on, I think, back in the summer. Eugenia was on a few days later, and we talked about obviously their careers and the movie. But it's finally now. Was it released in theaters yet, or this is the first release?
Okay, so Yes, this is the first release. Means I had a premiere in Hollywood.
Okay.
Where we got we got three awards: best film, best actor, and the best director. The movie
That's
got
right.
three awards. Yeah. Okay.
Now,
amazing at the TCL Chinese Theater in Hollywood. That's where we had our premiere. The premiere was sold out. We had 65 celebrities came on the red carpet. And we have another great news. We are having a premiere on the 17th in New York City.
That's right.
Releasing the movie on Amazon.
Right. It's at the Angelica Film Center.
Yes. I just heard that you said used to go to the Veterans Parade in New York City. So if you are in New York, please join. Please, I welcome you. And that will be great honor. If you can come, please let me know. I have to reserve your seat. We are pretty much sold out, but you are special. We'll make sure that you get your seat.
If I come, do I get to sit next to Eugenia? Will she be there?
I can do it. She's coming. No, hold on. She's coming. Eric Robert is coming. They both are flying in from LA. Actually, I want to do this on the November 13th, which is A, is Saturday. B, it's my birthday on 13th, but Eric is not available, so I have to do it on the Saturday. I have to do it on a Thursday.
Like, wow, that's amazing. You know what, Mukesh? I'm going to see if I can. Maybe my wife and I can come in and
please do that. Just let me know. You have to let me know. Email me or whatever the way you want. I can share my number or whatever you want. Then please, definitely, I would love you can come there.
That would be great. I appreciate it, but I'm going to try my best. I think I can, actually. I should be able to do it.
Yeah, you need to make
that. I'll make sure you sit with next to Eugenia. Eugenia will be sitting all the way in the back.
That's okay. For the movies, it's good to be in back. And wait, Phil, real quick, before you said that you guys won one of the awards for best director. Now, was that for you or is that for Jack Cook?
It's for the best directors, it goes for the both because I'm a co-director. We work together. Yes.
Gotcha.
For me, it's for the director. So it goes to both. Yes, definitely.
Good. All right, great.
Eric Roberts, I want to go see the movie for that alone. The trailer is exciting. The music, it just draws you in. So I want to see it for that. And Eric Roberts, I've been a huge Eric Roberts fan for many, 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 many years and love that guy. What was it like to direct Eric? How did you like working with him?
He is such a sweet guy. I'm telling you, such a friendly person.
Yeah.
Means honestly, whatever I ask him, he does it. I don't know whether he loves me or I don't know what the reason. But the best thing is he's an amazing person. We learned a lot from him on the stage at the time of premiere. This is the trailer. So that before what you saw, it was a teaser.
Right. Yeah,
you're missing the music. Yeah, but anyway.
What Mukesh on this system, I have to take the audio out so I could use it as B-roll, or else you can't hear us speak.
Okay.
But it was so you actually wrote this movie, and it's based off of a real life event, right?
It's based on a true event. I wrote the story. Of course, I hired to write the script someone else because I don't know how to write a script. But I did learn how to write a script. I wrote a script for my second movie, which is coming in. I'm going to start shooting on September of next month. That's when I'm going to start shoot for my next movie.
And that's a comedy, right?
I wrote the script for that. I'm sorry?
That one's a comedy, right?
That's a adult comedy. Yes.
Nice. Yes. What do you, does it have a name yet or just still a
I'm not revealing the name at this moment, but consider it's like based on American Woman. So you can say American Woman.
Okay.
Nice.
I love it. So you grew up in India, right?
Yes.
And spent a lot of time in Mumbai. How did you get into the film industry? How did that come about for you?
Okay. So as you know that I was born and raised in Mumbai, which is a Bollywood industry, mm-hmm. which is, I think 10 times larger than Hollywood.
Yeah, huge.
Because, we make so many movies. And I used to always active in dancing and in the music and all that. So I was like very much active in the college competition dance and all that. So I was always like that glamour life. I always wanted to have something. And then I used to live in LA in 2002 and 2003. That's where I went to Hollywood to learn how to make movies. So on that time, like I was like enthusiastic to make the movie. But as you know, Scott and Phil, how difficult it is to go to this industry. So I have, you know what, first of all, you need a lot of money. Okay, you need a lot of connection, which coming from India, you can imagine, I don't have no connection. And then what I was doing, I was saving the money every year. I kept this money on a side to make this project, to start this, so I don't need to ask and borrow the money from anybody else. So I put every money of my own, so I'm not stressed, I'm not desperate to release the movie and do anything. It took a little more time to release because we shot in 2019. And after that, there was a pandemic. But then some of the things, I wasn't convinced with the music. I wasn't convinced with the VFX work. So I changed all that just to make sure the music behind, the score is really good. Mm-hmm. So anybody going to watch the movie, I can guarantee they're going to love the movie. When we had the premiere sold out, everybody, they didn't say it's a good movie. Everybody said it's a great movie. So there's a difference between good and a great.
That's
so
amazing.
It's a really great movie.
Yeah, look at you guys right up in there in Times Square.
Wow.
Just, you know, on some of those big billboards, you know, it doesn't get any bigger than that. But did you find, what was it frustrating for you because you were ready to go with this movie and the pandemic hits? And now it kind of puts you off and it's like, you know, you're raring to go, ready to jump out of your skin for this film because you know how good it is. And you're just like, oh, now you got to wait. But here you are finally, you know, you're a week away from letting the world see what you created.
Okay. So it's like, honestly, Scott, it's a good question you asked me, which gives me an opportunity to tell the audience, you know, what to do when you are in that kind of situation. Yes, I was stressed. Because it's taking a long time, you know, when you put the money, everybody's waiting for it. So, yes, but at the same time.
Wait, Mikesh, Phil's not sleeping. I think he froze with his eyes closed. He's frozen. I'm going to take him out and let him. There he goes. He'll be back in a sec. Okay, you continue. Go ahead.
Okay. So I'm just saying that, of course, I was stressed for 2 years because the movie, and then you know, it takes time. And at the same time, I did not compromise on the quality.
Right.
I did not compromise on the music. I didn't want to compromise on the VFX work. I hired another person to make sure the VFX is right. Yes, I was stressed, but I believe in one thing. Whatever happens, happens for the reason. Okay. And it's always a good reason. If you think your life is set, you will not stress, you will be fine. Because you know what? Whatever has to happen is going to happen anyway.
Sure.
So why to stress? You know, exactly. Sometimes you are late and then you rush, you drive fast, you do so much thing. But I can give you, it's a true story. You must have heard it. You know, there was a guy, if you know that, what happened in 9/11. So one of the person, he had to drop his daughter to the school because she missed the school bus and he was really upset. And all the way dropping to the school, he was yelling at her, you know, because of you, I'm going to be delayed. I'm going to be late in the office. How can you miss your bus? Anyway, he dropped his daughter, took a train. He missed his train. And then he missed 9/11.
Yeah, wow.
Wow.
So this is the one story. I heard there was another story of the person got spilled the coffee on his shirt. So he had to change the shirt. So he had to go back and change the shirt. So he saved. You're like, I'm saying, so there's always a reason. You don't need to stress out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so that's what I want to tell everybody. You know what? Just be relaxed because, you know, and this is the message I'm giving. Life is uncertain. You don't know. You can count the money. You cannot count the time. You don't know when you're going to go. You will definitely go, though, one day.
Very true. Very true.
Yeah, definitely. And that's definitely true. And you talked about working with Eric Roberts. What about the beautiful Eugenia?
See, for me, I have so much respect for that woman. Okay, mm-hmm. This girl. She wears the crown. When I talk about the people, the best people, she wears the crown.
Right.
So you can, what I'm saying, you know, so she is the best. She's the best.
It's so
nice. Nobody can be better than her in film industry.
Right. You know, right. I think Eric told us this, but and I saw you had were being interviewed and you said it was just one of the funniest things. So you're making a movie about a guy who gets stuck in an elevator, and Eric and Jack actually got stuck in the elevator while you guys were shooting?
For 22 minutes.
Oh, man. Are you claustrophobic?
And listen, the best, what happened, the office was on the fourth floor because it's an office building.
Yeah.
So we had two elevators. One elevator we were shooting and one elevator we were going back and forth. And that back and forth, it got stuck. Wow. And then I had one of the person called me, like my executive director. I said, we got stuck in the elevator. He's just kidding. I don't pay attention. We called again. He said, no, we got stuck. Really, we got stuck. I said, really? Okay. Then I knew where the main board is. So I had to go put the switch off the main board, put it on again, and it can start. And my God, everybody was sweating. And then after that, Eric Robert has to go back and forth by stairs. He did not take elevator after that.
I wouldn't either.
Yeah. Yeah, no doubt, man. Because I'm very claustrophobic, and that would kill me.
But Kesh, as you were getting, you know, growing up and kind of interested in the business, who were some of like the big directors that you looked up to? Was it Bollywood people, or was it, you know, the Spielbergs of the world, the Martin Scorseses? Who were the guys who motivated you to do this?
So I tell you one thing. Motivated, like, I really wanted to do it. Of course, man, there are a few people in Bollywood, but the movie which more interested for me is my best movies ever. This is on Godfather. That's my all time best movie.
Sure. Okay?
And I love the story. I love the music. I love everything about that movie. Okay. And you can watch from anywhere and you're going to just fall into it.
Yeah.
Right. And then, you know, like, I like the movie Taken, you know, from the, what's his name?
Liam Neeson.
Yes. Okay. So I love those kind of movie. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but directed by Pierre Morel.
Okay. So yeah, when this situation happened about the elevator, I said, you know what? I want, this is a nice way to give a message to the people, you know, bring the awareness and, you know, tell the people how important the family is. And yeah, how important the life is. You know, that's the message I'm giving to the audience. The life is uncertain. Don't leave anything pending. You know, love your family.
Good advice. Good advice. Hey, Mukesh, sir, you mentioned Taken, which is one of my very favorite.
He doubles for Liam Neeson. Did you know that?
Okay.
But anytime I get a captive audience, and Scott gets tired of me doing this, but I always give a my little Taken excerpt, and it goes a little something like this. I don't know who you are. I don't know what you want. If you're looking for ransom, I can tell you I don't have money. But what I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills I have acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you. If you let my daughter go now, that'll be the end of it. I will not look for you. I will not pursue you. But if you don't, I will look for you. I will find you, and I will kill you. Anyway.
Love it. Phil, I love it. Love it. Love it.
Hey,
I'll find you.
I'll find you.
If you're ever looking for a bad guy or a good guy, you know, I'm a wannabe actor myself. So.
Mukesh, we're always ready. We're always ready to roll.
But Phil, where do you live?
I live in Oklahoma.
In Oklahoma. Okay.
Yeah, Phil's in Oklahoma. Very eclectic bunch here on the show, Mukesh. when you look at the movie, how long from the time inception in your brain did it take to Amazon on November 18th? What's the time frame? How long it took you from inception to completion to premiering this movie? How long was it?
Okay. If you talk, okay, so as I told you, we shot the movie in 2019, okay, in September. Okay, we finished in September end, let's say. And then we complete the movie in June of 2021.
But But how long, but when did you originally think of it? And then, and when was the script originally done?
Oh, that's 2015.
15. Okay. So many, you know, because several years. Okay. Yes.
Because see, I could have done it before, Scott, but as I mentioned, A, money, B, connection. So when I started, like, you know, I want to shoot in 2015, I put up one team together, it fell apart. Then I did another team in somewhere in 2018, fell apart. Then 2019, we got a team, and then luckily everything happened quickly, and we shot the movie.
Were you affected by the pandemic at all?
No, pandemic only affected in post production, because I shot the movie before pandemic. It was completed.
Yeah,
the shooting was completed. Yes, yes.
I love it. I love it, Mikesh. So you got this comedy coming out. Hopefully, you know, this movie, The Elevator, just kind of propels you into, you know, now you just steamroll into, you know, movies, you know, two, three a year. But it's just something that, you know, you're living out, you know, from when you were a young kid in India. You know, you're basically just fulfilling your dream right here. This is it.
That's true. That's true.
Yeah.
So I want to tell you one more thing. Okay. I am planning to bring my own platform exactly like Amazon and Netflix.
Really?
Why? Nice. Why I'm doing that? Because my nature, you have seen, you must have read about me. I like to give back. I like to help the people. Okay. Now, why I'm coming up with this platform, the idea of this bringing my own platform, because I've been to the process of having a tough time to release my movie. So people like me, there are many talented people. They don't know what to do. They don't know how to release the movie. Some people can shoot the movie, can't complete. Some people can shoot, complete, can't release. And it stays in the box. They can't do anything about it. They spend the money. They have a talent. And then, you know how these people are controlling the whole thing, all the big people controlling this industry. So when I'm going to come with my own platform where the producer can go and upload their movie directly on my platform.
Wow.
Okay. Like how, if you have anybody has a Vimeo on demand, they can do that. But Vimeo on demand is not very popular. People, you know, like, you know, I don't know whether so. And plus, my platform will be free subscription. There is no monthly fee.
You
only pay if you watch the movie. Like sometimes, like I was a member of Netflix. Okay, I was paying like $12.99 at the highest. I started with $8.99, then $9.99, then $12.99.
Right. Now it's $19.
I'm not a member anymore. But even though when $12.99, I hardly used to watch any movie. So I was paying $12.99 every month for no reason. Now people can download, they can have the app at no cost, and they only pay when they watch the movie.
Makes sense. So yeah, basically it's like on demand on your TV, you know, where you're getting, but for you, it could be, so anybody could if they have a movie that we want to release, they'll do it on your platform.
That's it. And I'm helping them to get the, if they need any marketing, we'll do the marketing. Of course, it'll be cost, but it won't be so much cost. Like not like they have to spend their arms and legs. It's not like that. It will be very nominal cost. We'll have a rating system there. They can rate the system just only for $500. They don't need to spend like $3,000 to rate the movie.
Right.
I'm doing all that to how can I help to the independent filmmaker.
That's amazing, Mikesh. Yeah, that would be an amazing thing, because so many people are shooting movies these days, whether it's with their phones, you know, with a full crew, you know, a lot of creative folks out there who need that platform to, you know, distribution, if you will, to, you know, get eyeballs on the product.
Yeah. Right. And that's great that you're willing to give back like that, because you've been there. You came to this country. You didn't have, you know, you didn't know anybody, or you didn't have any support. And now you're going to make that option available for people. And speaking of that, coming from your origins, what advice would you give somebody who's just starting out? Or what advice would Mikesh now give Mikesh then?
Okay. So I would say right now, see, after I've been to this process, first of all, I would say anybody, trust yourself. Trust in your project. Okay. And don't just trust blindly, you know, like you have to see it, like whether it's going to work or not going to work. And if you do anything, then do not worry about it. Do not stress, because my philosophy is whether I win or I learn, I don't lose.
Okay,
love good. It. I love good it.
Yeah, I love that. Whether I win or learn, I don't lose, because you know what? Even though if you lose, you're learning something. Right. If I've given a money to somebody just to borrow the money and he doesn't pay me, he taught me a lesson.
Yeah,
absolutely. That's so true.
Very
true. That's true. Yeah.
You know, I took and I try to tell people to stay in there. You know, you're gonna fall down. You know, I submitted for over 700 parts before I got a national commercial. 700 parts I submitted for. So you have to keep working, and you can't worry about somebody telling you no, because you're gonna hear a lot of no's. So, but yeah, great advice, sir.
Mikesh, it's an amazing story. The movie, of course, is The Elevator with Eric Roberts, Eugenia Kuzmina. Matt Rife is in it. Is it Avery Ilardi? She's the young lady.
One is Avery Ilardi, and another girl is Avery Morris.
Okay.
They're both girls. I'm telling you, they worked so well. They acted so well. You know, to work with the kids is not easy.
Yeah.
But oh my God, these girls were amazing. They did a great job. Now these both girls are coming also on my premiere. They were in LA also. They're coming to New York also.
And the premiere, of course, November 17th, next Wednesday, Angelica Film Center in New York. And then on the 18th, it's available to everybody on Amazon.
Perfect. Yes.
Yeah. And I got to tell you, sir, before you go, that your story is very, very inspirational to me and to a lot of people. Thank you for what you do. And I want everybody to go watch The Elevator when it comes out.
Yeah, we're going to check it out. Mikesh, by the way, I've been with WWE for 12 years. I am huge over in India. Huge.
Wow.
I have more people because India is a huge WWE market.
1.3 billion people.
Yeah, and it's a huge WWE market. And I do all the international shows in like 40 countries. I get more mail from people in India than it's unbelievable. And I always I tell Phil, I can't even leave my condo in India. I can't walk the streets because everybody jumps all over me.
But everybody wants to suplex him.
It's a fantastic market.
Scott, is there love for you?
Yeah, well, listen, you know, I understand that. Mikesh, listen, congratulations. Your story's amazing. And it's next, when you're done with this comedy, please come back and we'll promote the heck out of it as well.
Definitely. So, Scott, you let me know. I don't know how you want to let me know, but if you want to come, miss after the
absolutely, evening. I will. I'll let Ruthie know from the PR company, and we'll see if we can work that out.
Perfect. Great.
Mikesh, thank you, my friend. Have a great day.
You too. Thanks. Bye bye.
Continued success, bud.
Okay. Great. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Phil, what a great guy.
Oh man.
What a great guy. What a story. Yeah. Just what a story.
Yeah, an amazing story. He's got a big heart. He wants to give back. It's just a very, very inspirational.
By the way, he also sponsors a free medical camp in India. I was reading about a free where the medicine, everything is free for the patients. He takes care of the whole thing.
Wow.
Mikesh Modi.
That's awesome.
I don't know many Indian American filmmakers who are premiering movies these days. But let me just put it up there one more time. It's The Elevator, right there. Eric Roberts, Eugenia Kuzmina, and it coming out next week is the premiere. Amazon, the 18th. Phil, imagine I go. I get to sit next to Eugenia Kuzmina.
Man, you got to make that.
Oh, I gotta go now. Now I gotta go.
Your wife will sit between you two, but still,
she might. She'd be like, just go without me. I don't care. She doesn't care. Anyway, bud, listen. Lots more show to do. Jeff Coffey's coming up in just a second. One of my favorite guests. I always say that when we're talking about Jeff. It's a very talented guy. It's Veterans Day today, Philly kid. If you're just joining us, here's a little shot of you from back in the day. Look at you. Look at you with the rifle. What kind of rifle is that?
That is an M16.
An M16. Jesus, look at you.
There are many like it, but this one is mine.
You'd go on to be an Oklahoma City Police Force sniper, right?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. All right, Jesus, Louise. And here's a shot of my father, who looks exactly like me, or I look exactly like him.
Yeah.
And it's wild. It's wild when you look.
Can't deny that.
Yeah. I mean, he's got to be in his early 20s in that shot. Of course, I'm a when I was younger, Phil, I was a little thinner. You know what I mean? Yeah. And coming up later on, I know you're going to do a little singing, but let's talk about Jeff. I want to bring him in. Singer, songwriter, of course, we were talking about it earlier. Former bassist and lead vocals for Chicago, doing a little touring with Don Felder from the Eagles. I mean, the guy is, you talk about a rock star.
Yes.
Literally. Jeff is it. And, when he came on with us back in June, we were talking about, he's got an album called Origins that came out a couple of years ago, and it's all covers of some of your favorite songs. He sang for us. He was amazing. Here's a little bit of Jeff here. And then we'll bring him in on the other side. Of course, Suki out in Phoenix shooting some stuff at TLC. She'll be back with us Hamana next week. Here's Jeff, and then we'll bring him in. Why? We are feeling
Nice.
Jeff, how are you, buddy?
How you guys doing?
Oh, good, we're good. Doing well, my man. Boy, when I hear your voice, man, you just bring me back to high school.
Yeah.
You bring me back
to high school. Were good times.
Man, mid 80s. It just, Journey and Chicago and
or late 70s.
Yeah, all that stuff. Like some of us a little earlier, but
hey, I gotta tell you, Jeff. Scott said you're gonna be on the show, and so of course I jump on my phone and start listening to Jeff Coffey music, and I was listening to Origins. I'm like, okay, cover songs. Everybody does cover songs, cool. So, and then the first one I listened to, I must have been through about him, and the goosebumps just popped up all over me, and I'm like, oh my god! So I spent the rest of the afternoon just listening to all those songs,
man,
which are like the fabric of music history, at mine anyway, and just brought back so many memories. And I think that's just the appeal. You sang song, I Can't Make You Love Me, Maggie May, Waiting for a Girl Like You. I mean, the fabric of the history of a lot of people's lives, and I think,
soundtrack,
I think that's
right
the
there.
Appeal. It's awesome. Awesome.
Well, thank you for that. I appreciate it. And really, that was the purpose behind doing the record. Not only it was a great trip down memory lane for me to dive into these songs and sing these songs, but I hope that everyone that listens to the record will also have that trip down memory lane too, because as it affected you, these songs affected me too. So it was a really fun record to do.
I remember you were last time you were on, you sang Little Maybe I'm Amazed and Watch a Magic Power, which is always one of my favorites. We last time we saw you was in June. Things have loosened up obviously a lot since then, and I know you're getting back out there. You're out in front of a live audience now.
Yeah, starting to put some shows together. I have shows booked in Florida for December, and then there we go. Yeah. And then I'm going to be going to South Carolina and Texas, in February, doing some shows there. So things are, there's a lot of groups that have been out there traveling and playing a lot of parts of the United States already since earlier this year.
Yeah.
But it's still, things are different in different parts of the country, artists and venues trying to agree on mandates, no mandates or whatever. And a lot of cancellations still. So, but it hasn't fully opened up yet, but enough to where I'm anxious to get back out there and play. And so I'm excited about getting out there.
I just came back
to some shows in Texas.
Yeah, I see that.
In September, a few months ago. So it was great to be back out there again.
And it says an acoustic evening. So is it just, is it you? Is there a backup band or just you?
No, I'm just booking, you know, for the rest of this year and into the beginning of next year, just booking a lot of solo acoustic things, going out there and getting into some markets that I haven't been to before myself. And then, you know, hopefully if things go well, by mid-year, hopefully maybe, I'll have a band and I'll go out with a band and do full band shows, which I'm really excited to do. So
nice.
You know, you've had a awesome, you know, long time career and you're still killing it. And I always like to ask people, what is your secret for staying fit and healthy and lean and mean, man? I mean, seriously, a special diet, exercise regimen, what is it?
Whiskey.
There you go. Phil, I've been telling you that for whiskey and tequila.
No. Well, thank you for saying that, but I wish I'd be in the shape that I was in even 20 years ago. But I live by that adage of all good things in moderation, you know. Okay. So I try to stop myself from, you know, indulging too much with the food because I love food. Everybody does. But it's just trying to stay active and stay busy, stay moving. You know, that's really the key.
Yeah, you're definitely doing it.
And, you know, I have a long way to go yet to get to where I want to be physically, you know, especially after the whole pandemic and everything.
Oh, yeah.
I got COVID this past summer.
Oh, after we saw you, you got COVID?
Yes.
Wow.
Knocked me down for 2 weeks. And you still, and it's different for everybody, but you still feel a little bit of residual things from it, you know, especially that heaviness in the chest, you know?
Yeah.
So I got to get your cardio back up. And it's a slow process.
Yes.
But
yes.
At least I feel I'm extremely protected now, you know, antibodies. So, but I've never been sick like that. Nothing has ever affected my voice like that before in my life. That was pretty radical. 2 weeks.
Oh, wow. God. Listen,
Glad you're doing well.
Do you want to, I want to talk to you, of course, a little bit about Chicago, but you want to sing a little something first?
Sure.
What do you like? Sure, a little something from Origins This Time Around, I know is the most recent.
How about, I'll do one for you, man.
Must have been through about a million girls. Love the man I leave them alone. I didn't care how much they cried, no sir. Their tears left me cold as a stone. But then I fooled around and fell in love.
Such a great song. It's that easy. I know one of our, when I put up the promotion, the pick that you were coming on today, I know one of our audience members, I got to try, she said she had recently purchased Origins and she thought it was amazing.
Awesome.
So 2016, you get this call out of nowhere to audition for Chicago, right? You get the gig, right? You get the gig. What was that? Do you get like, does the heart start pumping a little bit when you get that first phone call and you're like, oh man, look, where'd this come from?
Well, it was ironic. I was just coming back from meeting my youngest son, and he was in elementary school at the time, for lunch. And coming back, I got a call from my guitar player friend, Chris Nix. He says, hey man, you're going to get a call probably here soon from the guitar player from Chicago.
Wow.
Chicago. long story short, yeah, we talked. Keith Howland, a longtime guitarist for Chicago. We talked and told me what was going on, and they sent me some live tracks minus the bass and vocals, and I did a video audition, three songs. Actually, ended up being four songs, and so I videoed myself, and then I played live to the tracks and recorded it and sent it to them. So it was a live,
like video. a self audition, yeah.
Exactly. They wanted to see how you how you sound, how you look, and how you can play the bass and all that stuff. So after those four songs that I sent in, they all liked what they heard, and basically, at that point, I had about 2 weeks to prep the full show, 32, 33 songs.
Wow.
Singing probably 2/3 of them. So I had to memorize the lyrics. And
holy
so
cow.
It was crunch time. I lived in my studio for 2 weeks. And then I went up for the run through audition, if you will, with the band. And very next night was the show, my first show. And then I went on the 2 week run with them, and it was full steam ahead ever since that day.
So, that's amazing. You remember the first? What was the first Chicago song you sang first night? What was it?
I sang?
Yeah.
Well, the opener song is Introductions. It's a song called Introductions. So I don't sing that one
right.
Backups. But the second song in the set is my first vocalist is Question 6768. So, and that's kind of a high song, so you have to be well warmed up by the time song number two comes around.
Right.
So,
oh my goodness.
Yeah.
That's got to be amazing.
Wow.
And then a couple of years later, what was it, 2019 or 2018, you one of the members had left, and then like a week later, you left as well. I kind of read the story. So was it mainly the touring, the schedule, and you just really just needing to be with the family?
Well, there were various reasons. I think it would be safe to say that was part of it. That was one of the big, maybe the root of the problem. But it was there were other things, other factors involved too. But it was pretty extensive. You know, I mean, they were roughly averaging 80 shows a year, roughly give or take. Then when I got on, it was I got on like a month after the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction. Which elevated the band's profile, more shows. And then that holiday season came on, the documentary came out, elevated the band's profile,
yeah, sure.
more shows. So, you know, it was, I was 2017, I was gone from the house 270 days.
Wow.
So it was pretty extensive touring. I mean, that being said, I was having an absolute blast. Musically speaking, it was the most incredible experience to be on stage with that ensemble of musicians every night for those 2 hours. It was like everything that I ever dreamt of doing as a young kid who picked up an instrument. You know, it was musically, it was just so gratifying and so much fun. I left. Clearly, to leave a gig like that, it would have to be for very good reasons, and it was. So.
Unreal. Well, listen, I'm gonna take you back for a second on stage. I think maybe you were at the Borgata with Chicago here. Let's take a little. Not a bad way to spend the night, I got to tell you.
That was on the tour with Earth, Wind, and Fire, which that was like more fun than you should be legally allowed to have on stage. And that was so much fun. And we did a big six song encore at the end of that show, which is a spectacle. 21 guys, six horns, and playing each other's songs and trading
That must have been
amazing. Trading vocal licks with Philip Bailey and trading bass licks with Bernie. I mean, it was just like, how do you have this much fun?
I know you had fantasy in there, right?
You mean the song?
The song.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We didn't play that one, but no, that just you know, we played. Geez, what did we do? We did Do You Remember?
Yeah,
21st night of September. So many great songs, and it was so much fun. Those are great guys. Those guys are awesome.
Yes, yes.
What a great life, man. Great life. And I was just looking at the list of one of the magazines had top 50 Chicago songs of all time, and number one was 25 or 64. That was their, I guess, their opinion or their, you know, their poll. But it was God, there's so many Chicago songs.
So many.
Yeah. It's amazing. Fine. Philly, what's your favorite? Listen, Jeff, Phil, he's got more followers than all of us put together. Okay,
I don't know about that.
This guy puts out songs. The women love him around the world, and he's like a viral sensation. But Philly kid, what's one of your favorite Chicago songs?
Oh, the one that he just mentioned. You know, when you hear
Fooled
that,
Around.
No, the
which
the,
one?
25 or 64. You know when you're
and
you know, I guess the reason that sticks out because again, when I was in high school, that was one of the big ones during football season that the band would kick
right
into,
as soon as you hear the horns, right?
Yeah, and when you hear that. Bah, 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 but you the goosebumps and you're like, all right, this is awesome. But
it's a strong tune. Is one of their strongest. I mean, it usually ends up being the show closer. It just gets people on their feet and gets them fired up.
I found this online. So you got a little I'll Be Home for Christmas album out there.
Yeah. Well, it's not an album, but it's single.
A single. Yeah. Oh, I'll Be Home for Christmas, the single.
Yes.
You know what? We're close enough to December. You wanna hit a little of that one?
Oh man.
Or is that too? Do you need a different?
You know what? What's funny is that I'm getting ready to do some shows in December, and I had not played that song in forever, and I got to relearn it. I got to like, what did I do there?
Take us through it.
I will.
Oh, all right. I was gonna say, take us through while you learn it. I'm sure it sounds amazing anyway.
Hey, would you mind doing I Can't Make You Love Me? Another.
Is that on Origins? Is that on?
Well, that's on Origins.
Yeah.
But that is one, and along with this Christmas song and another one, New York Minute. Okay. I did that just piano and vocals, and Michael Lomardian, the great Michael Lomardian, phenomenally successful producer, was gracious enough to lend his piano chops, which are amazing. You know, and that's him on all that early Steely Dan Asia stuff.
Yeah.
He produced Christopher Cross, Michael Bolton, Whitney Houston, Donna Summers, Peter Cetera, Amy Grant. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. And it was such a joy to make this music with him. But that's another one where I never learned it on guitar because he played it on piano.
You didn't have to. But, you know what? You play whatever you want. Just pick whatever you feel comfortable playing.
Well, you know what? How about I do something for the veterans today?
There you go.
Oh, nice.
And I just like to say to all of the current people in our military and all the people who have served before, you know, in this crazy times that we live in right now, we all need heroes. Those people are the real heroes. You know,
absolutely.
Because they have vowed to put themselves in harm's way to protect us, our way of life. And it doesn't get any more heroic than that. So, you know, I've had a lot of family members, uncles and my grandfather and my father-in-law was in the Army. My brother is currently a career Air Force.
Really?
God bless our military, man.
Yeah,
God bless
them.
So, thank you. Thank you for saying that.
A little American song here. There's a young man in a t-shirt, listen to a rock and roll station. He's got a greasy hair, a greasy smile. He says, hello, this must be my destination. Oh, but ain't that America?
been counted for dream. All for you and me. Oh yeah. Yeah.
Nice.
God yes. bless our military. God bless you, people. Yes.
So good. So good.
Thank you, Jeff.
Listen,
thank you,
man.
So much. Awesome.
I just want to put this up again. I want to make sure people can see it. So December 14th, you're in St. Petersburg.
Yes.
December 16th, you're in Boca. Then over in January, you're going to South Carolina, back to Florida. And everybody, you know, if they want to come out and see you, they can get right on your website, right? What's the how do they get to your site?
Yeah, they can go right to my website. It's all one stop there. It's Jeff Coffey, COFFEY.com. And
oh, okay.
You go to the tour page, and all of these shows are on there. The links are there to the shows. So you come see me, people. You know, I'm looking forward to getting out there again, playing in front of people. It's just going to be an evening of music and storytelling and fun. So
beautiful. Now, are you nice. ever come around the New York area? Anything?
Well, here's the you know, with COVID and everything. When I released Origins in 2020, I was getting ready to. It was like towards the beginning, actually, right around Christmas time of 19, and I was in the process of booking shows up in the New Jersey, New York area. It's going to go to Daryl's house and places like that. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
And I was so excited about it. And then, I was on the road with Don Felder, and we were doing. Couple of the rock cruises. We were on the Rock Legends cruise right at the very tail end of February into the 1st of March of 2020. And that's when you really started hearing things on the news about COVID. And then about a week after we got off the ship, the brakes went on. Everything shut down for a year and a half. I mean, completely shut down. So everything that I was gearing up for at the beginning of 2020 had to has now been on a 2-year back hold. So, I definitely want to get up there. That's the plan. Winter's coming, you know.
Yeah.
So, but it may be, you know, spring. Hopefully, I'd like to get up there and hit those areas. New York.
But yeah, Atlantic City. Yeah, absolutely.
Atlantic City, absolutely.
Love
that's
to
the
come
plan.
See
that's the plan for this year, this coming year.
Beautiful. Well, listen, before you go, and I know you did it last. Can you give me like a minute of Magic Power?
Such a great song.
Love it.
Something's at the edge of your mind. You don't know what it is. Something you open to find. You're not sure what it is. But then you hear the music, and it all comes crystal clear. Music does the talking. Says the things you wanna hear. Yeah. Wild and free, got the magic power of music in me. I'm wild and free, got the magic power of music in me.
And I got to tell you, Jeff, you inspire lots and lots of people.
So good.
I know in my case, you really, really do. Keep doing what you're doing, man. Keep working hard, and we're all enjoying it.
Jeff, I told you last time you were going to be big in this business, and see, it's working it's working out, bud.
Well, hey, I appreciate you so much, you guys, having me on the show. And
thank you. And you know,
I'd love for you guys to come see me somewhere, and I got a new record out that I put up this year, and so, you know.
Oh, wait.
Onward and upward.
Hold on, because I have that. Is it this time around? Is that
the
one? Yeah, there you go. Yep. Okay, so people can get that on your site as well, right?
Absolutely. They can get it on my site, physical, but it's also available digitally everywhere. So
beautiful. And this is all originals or still other stuff?
All original. That's all original. 12 tracks, brand new tracks.
Beautiful,
wow.
Beautiful.
Nice,
and
that's
how,
what I did over the COVID break. I made a record.
That's all. Got to be productive. Jeff, that's listen, right. Man, thank you so much, my friend. It's an absolute pleasure. Thanks for coming on. I know it was kind of last minute. And
hey,
when you start coming up in this area, please come back and we'll promote the heck out of it.
Yes, we got to get together and have a little cocktail.
Absolutely, my friend. Whiskey, Phil. A little whiskey, my man.
All right. More of the whiskey. I'm coming.
Jeff, thank you, my man. Have fun, bud.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks,
so
Jeff.
Much.
See you later.
The best.
Happy
Take care, pal. You
thank
too.
You.
Oh, man. Phil, he's insane. He's incredible.
Wow. That dude is awesome, man. Awesome. Wow.
So good. I mean, does his voice brings you back to when, you know, I mean, we're all around the same age, but he, when I was in high school, he was probably, you know, doing something a little better than I was doing. but it just reminds me of all of those, you know, those bands. His voice is amazing.
Yeah.
And, I mean,
you know,
he gets those high notes and God, so good.
Still. Yeah, man.
So good. So Jeff Coffey and Mukesh Modi, what a great show today. Philly Kid, did you know, I was reading this the other day because it's like what, the 35th, 40th anniversary of Rocky IV. Sylvester Stallone got hit during the filming that put him in the hospital. Like he almost died from one of the scenes, and it's actually, they kept that scene in because it was so realistic. The guy literally got pummeled and like he couldn't, they had to bring him to the emergency room. But
I remember that story. He basically got like his heart.
His heart.
There's a damage to his heart, and they actually thought there for a while that he was going to really have some problems, but
yeah, his blood pressure, his heart, and he was just, you know, he was freaking out. There were nuns around him in the emergency room, so it was wild. But
he gave his all. You know, as an actor, I don't think I would let Dolph Lundgren punch me anywhere.
Right, I know.
or Mr. T.
Even half strength.
Yeah, or Carl Weathers. None of those guys.
Man. What great movies. Great movies. When Rocky came out, I mean, it was so great. He's in my turtles, Guff and Link. it was so good, man. Everybody would walk around going, hey, yo, Rocky.
Yeah, and his old coach. What was his old coach? Mick.
Mick. Mickey. Yeah, yeah.
You're gonna eat lightning and crap thunder, Rock.
Right. Women weak in legs, kid. Women. When Mickey comes to his house, to his apartment, now you want to be my manager. You be my manager, Mick. This place stinks. This whole place stinks. Oh, so good. And Paulie, just great casting in that movie, man.
Yeah, awesome. Awesome stuff.
Anyway, Philly Kid, Veterans Day, you are our number one main man when it comes to veterans. And, you know, even though today's Veterans Day, we have basically all year been promoting HeroForLife.us, benefiting disabled veterans. There's a lot of apparel there. Actually, I'm wearing one of the shirts right here. You use our code USA1, you get 20% off. We do not make money off of any of that stuff. It's all for disabled vets. We thought we'd have some fun and do the mugs, which seem to be a big hit, but you got all the apparel you can get. For men, women, and kids. So just go on there, especially today, Veterans Day, HeroForLife.us. If you put in our promo code USA1, you get 20% off. And it doesn't cost you a dime to hear Phil sing, because just like last Veterans Day, we had the Veterans Choir, and then you sang a couple songs, Philly Kids. So the floor is yours, my friend. Mini concert coming up.
Yeah. So let's start off with a little bit of, and I'm just going to sing about three songs. I'm just going to sing them all the way through without stopping.
Nice. I'm going to, and you know what? I'm going to lay back and I'm going to enjoy, my friend.
All right. Oh, beautiful, for spacious skies. For amber waves of gray, for purple mountain majesties, above the fruited plain, America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood, from sea to shining sea. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring. From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we fight our country's battles in the air, on land and sea. First to fight for right and freedom, and to keep our honor clean. We are proud to claim the title of United States Marines. Fighting soldiers from the sky, fearless men, they jump and die. Men who mean just what they say, these brave men of the Green Beret, silver wings upon their chest. These are men, America's best. 100 men will test today, but only 3 earn the Green Beret. Put silver wings on my son's chest. Make him one of America's best. He'll be a man, he'll test one day, and he will earn the Green Beret. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
You know, to me, Veterans Day means that we remember all the sacrifices made by all the members of our military, all those who chose, they raised their hand and they went to serve their country, or even, and the ones who were actually called, you know, selective service or the draft, they went and they served their country. They sacrificed their blood, their sweat, and their tears, and their lives by the millions so that we could live in the freest, greatest country in the history of the planet. And I was honored and had the privilege to be a part of that. And I pray for the families and the friends of everyone who their loved ones did not come back. And we are a great country, and it's due to the sacrifices of all these men and women. And remember them, just and never forget, because without them, we wouldn't be where we are now. Philly kid. I'll leave that right.